Well, here we are again today. We're in the kitchen and it's the holidays. Thanksgiving is just a few days away. And I have been cooking candy all day long. And I am just having the best time because I love doing this stuff. And I'm going to cook a recipe for y'all today. It's an old-fashioned candy that my Granny Cochran cooked for us at the holidays. So let's make date roll today. Let's turn around here to the stove. Okay, here's my pot. I've got 3 cups of sugar in it, and we need to add some more ingredients. We need to add 1 cup of evaporated milk.
Giving to others, being with family, spending time together, making sure that those around you feel loved.
Happy holidays from the Christmas music station. Magic 93.7.
All right, here we go. Now we need to add 2 tablespoons of karo. Can you hear the Christmas music in the back? All right, so I'm not gonna measure the karo. I'm gonna do just like I do with the fudge. I'm just gonna dump 2 globs of karo in it. That's 1 and 2. And we need to turn the fire on and get it cooking. I'm going to cook it just a tad above medium, just like I cook the pralines, just a hair above medium heat. Stir it all up good. Okay, now it's going to take a while for this candy to cook. I've got to cook it to the softball stage. And like I have told y'all in other videos, I don't use a candy thermometer. I never had one growing up at home. Mama didn't have one. And so I learned how to cook candy without a candy thermometer. I don't know if many of you have heard of date roll before, date roll or date nut roll. But it's just an old-fashioned, old-timey candy that my Granny Cochran made every year at Thanksgiving and Christmas. And so this recipe was passed down to me from my Granny Cochran. Granny made it. She passed the recipe down to her daughter, Aunt Dixie, and Aunt Dixie passed it down to me. So now I'm making it, and I'm passing these recipes down to my daughter, Rebecca. Which Rebecca has a business, Sweetwater Candies and Crafts. So if you want to order some candy, if you don't want to make these candies yourself, you can look up her website, Sweetwater Candies and Crafts, and you can order some candy if you would like to. All right, the candy's been cooking for about 15 minutes. Let's test it in some cold water. See if it will make a softball yet. Here's a bowl with some cold water in it. Drop a few drops in there. Okay, now I'm going to see if I can get it to roll up into a ball. Okay, it's not quite making a soft ball. See, it won't hold its shape. It's just smushy. So, but it tastes good. So we're gonna let it cook a little bit longer. Look at here. I have pots on all 4 of my burners here. And I'm making candy with all of it. So I've got right here, I'm making my date roll. Back here, I've got fudge. Over here, I've got divinity. And right here, I've got pralines. So I have got it cooking today. All right, let's test the candy again. All right, it's still not holding its shape. So we gotta let it cook a little more. All right, y'all, we're gonna try it again. The candy's been cooking for about 25 minutes. See where we're at. Do we have a softball yet? Oh-ho, I think we might be there. Okay. Get it. Let's turn around here and take a look. Okay, here's the piece of candy. Look at that. I can roll it around in my fingers. It's holding its shape, but yet it's soft. See, you can smash it. It's not hard or firm. This is a soft ball. There's our softball. I'm going to eat this softball. Our candy's ready for the next step. So let me get it off of the burner so I can stop it from cooking. There we are. It's off the burner. Now, what we need to do next is we need to put a little butter in there. So let me get some butter. I believe it's about 1 tablespoon is what I need to put in there, so I'm going to put that in there. Let that melt. We got to put in some vanilla. 1 teaspoon of vanilla. All right, there we go with that. Now, this is date roll, so we've got to have some dates. So I've got a plate over here where I have my dates already cut up. It takes 8 ounces of dates. I bought a package that was whole dates and I cut them up. You don't want to use the dates that have sugar on them. Just use the dried dates that do not have sugar on them. If you use the dates that have sugar on them, it tends to make the candy have a sugary texture. And so it's better to use the dates without the sugar. Okay, let's see. Here's my dates right there. I'm glad the lid was on this vanilla since I turned it over. Now, so here's my dates. I've already got them chopped up. And here over on the side, I have some candied cherries. The recipe calls for 8 candied cherries. I've got those chopped up as well. I've got 1 date left here that's whole. I wanted to show it to you before I chopped it up. Okay, so this is the whole date right here. I'm going to chop this one up. Then we're ready to put this into our candy. We're going to stir this around, let these dates kind of melt into this candy, the dates and the candied cherries. All right. And just stir this around some. Okay, let me let that set for just a second and I'll talk to you about what we're going to do next. Now, I've got to roll this date roll out because it's a date roll. So I'm trying to think what you call it. It's like a flour sack kitchen towel. That's what I've got, that I'm going to lay it out on that and roll that towel up, and that will be able to shape and form a date roll. I'm going to have to, so my towel, it's damp. I wet it and then I wrung it out. So it's a damp flour sack towel. I'll have to sprinkle some powdered sugar on it, and I'm going to roll that date roll in the powdered sugar. I need powdered sugar on all sides of it. And we'll roll it up, and then we're going to let it cool. Okay, let's get back around here and look. All right, good. So we're going to have to let this candy cool enough. We're going to have to let it cool down and cool enough to where I can actually dip it out onto the towel, and it will kind of hold its shape. So that'll take, you know, a few minutes for that to happen. I still have pecans that I need to add in here. So I'm going to go ahead and add the pecans, and the pecans will help cool the candy down. 2 cups of broken pecans. So let me get that stirred in there. Get this kind of where you can see it better, maybe. Okay, so what I'm going to have to do now with this candy, I'm just going to have to let it sit and cool a little bit, and I'll stir it, you know, every 30 seconds. I'll stir it, see if it's holding its shape yet, and when I get ready to put it out on the towel, I'll get back with y'all. All right, now here we are at the bar now. This stuff is ready to come out of here. Got to get it on this towel, dipping it out. Right, a little bit more. I know you can't hardly see my pot, kind of how I've got it right here, but I'm just dipping everything out of the pot. Getting all the candy out of the pot and onto this towel. Okay. In the sink. Let me scrape the rest of this off of this big spoon here. And then we're going to have to try to fold this towel around it and shape this date roll into a roll. All right. Here we go. Just going to roll my towel around it, start shaping it, trying to fit it all together, get it all to come together. And that's what we look like so far. This. Going to be a big fat date roll. this is coming together good, y'all. This is great. This is what it's supposed to be doing. We'll be able to get some powdered sugar on it here in just a little bit. And we'll let it set, probably let it set overnight and go ahead and cool off real good. And then our date roll, it'll be made. Almost got all of my candy made. I'm having a blast. If you love what you do, it's not work. All right, look at that. That's looking nice. Now, let me put some powdered sugar on here, and we want to roll it in this powdered sugar. Spread powdered sugar on it. Okay. Let's turn it over. Sugar on it. Ooh, a piece fell off. Mm. Yummy. We've almost got it covered with powdered sugar now. All right, can y'all see that? Doesn't that look delicious? All right, this is our date roll. I'm going to roll it up in this towel. There's another piece. I'm going to roll it up in the towel. Like I said, we're going to let this cool probably overnight. And then I can show y'all how to slice it once it gets cooled. All right. Oh, let me show y'all something. Let me see if I can turn this camera around. The candy factory has been up and running today. Can y'all see all of this candy I've got laid out here? Like I said, I've been cooking candy all day and I'm not through yet. All right, the date roll is ready to slice. Already sliced one piece off. I'm using a serrated knife, because it will slice the candy more cleanly. It'll make a cleaner cut. Just put it right here. Slice it right through. And there's your piece of date roll. I think I should taste it. That's what I think. Mmm. That is so, so good. Okay, so my date roll is ready. So I have put a piece of freezer paper up under this towel, and I'm going to roll the date roll over onto this piece of freezer paper, and that's how I'm going to store it. I'm going to wrap it up in this piece of freezer paper. Get this towel out of the way. I see all kinds of pieces of candy to eat here. Okay, get my towel out of the way. Let's roll this over to the edge of my freezer paper. All right, now we're going to wrap this freezer paper around it. I'm going to fold it over it, just like that. kind of get the sugar up in there. And then I'm just gonna roll it up. All right, I've got it rolled up. Now, I'm just gonna take the ends and see if I can get this where you see it. Take each end and fold it under. Get this other end here. Fold it under. And there's my bake roll. Got it all wrapped up. It's ready just to, I'll just leave it out on the counter. I guess you could probably put it in the refrigerator if you wanted to. But there's a bake roll. All right, I hope y'all have enjoyed this video on how to make a date roll. And I hope y'all have a happy Thanksgiving and a Merry Christmas. And I'll see y'all in another video real soon.